So today I want to talk about my dad's Bullet 500. So it's a Mashishmo model with an AVL engine. So yesterday I got down to washing it and I applied some varnish that I talked about in my previous video. So if y'all don't know what that is, y'all can check it out. So And to the chrome, I applied some chrome polish. So today I thought about, just making a video and showing you all how it's come out. So this is the bike. So you can see that it has a disc brake in front. Yeah, the chrome's wearing off a little bit, but then that's the natural process. So I applied the varnish here to the headlight console, so you can see it's got a nice reflective shine now. So that's what the varnish does, it increases the reflective power of the surface. And it has this, we had to put this shade on, my dad put it on. And great thing about this bike is it's got self-start, so that's something that really comes in handy. I mean, it's got its pros and cons. So since it runs entirely on the battery, there are chances that the bike, I mean, if the wiring is faulty or bad, it can just go dead. So that possibility is there. We've changed the speedometer to a classic. No, the speedometer had gotten bad, so we changed it to this. I've applied it here also. So the varnish, I tried my best not to apply it to the chrome, but I mean, it got on at some places because the thing is, it doesn't stick well to chrome. So here also, it's come out nice. The chassis, at least from the outside, it's gone on quite well. Initially, when this is a 2007 model, so I was pretty young back then. And as I grew up, I tried fiddling around with things and messed up a few things. So if you can see the engine, it's got all scratches and the surface is really uneven. So that's because I tried buffing it myself with a cup brush and that resulted in a lot of scratches. So it's basically the same AVL engine on my Thunderbird. I mean, I have a Thunderbird. So but this is a higher capacity. This is a 500 cc. It's got a different carburetor with bigger jets. This is the old air filter box. I mean, it's just for show. There's nothing in it. The actual air filter is here in this the circular circle. So even here the varnish has come out pretty good. Stock exhaust, we put on this carrier because it helps when you need to carry stuff, because on a motorcycle you can't really carry much. The rear wheel is a Stepney that we're using because the original tire is worn out, and this tire was actually on my Thunderbird, so I changed to a smaller wheel rim. So then I put this on the 500. So this is the rear. Okay, now we come on to this side. So yeah, pretty much. The standard stuff, I mean, the seat setup is different. It's different from my bike. The mud guards are a lot like my Thunderbird ends here, so this has that extra mud guard. Basically, a more bulky bike, and it's quite heavy. So this is the rear. So the varnish has come out very nice even on this side. Now this on the battery box is something I did when I was a kid and in college. So yeah, you'll have to excuse me for that. Then even the side casing here, I told you I tried buffing it, so there are a couple of scratches, but that will go in time. I mean, with polishing. So let's be positive. So this is the fuel tap area, chrome tank, and this logo also I did when I was a kid. So yeah. Can't judge me on these things. Yeah, so even here on the chassis, varnish came out very nice. Here in front also. So overall, it's basically a protective layer, and it's a protective measure taken to save the paint, and it also adds a very nice look. So I recommend it to all motorcycle users and motorcycle owners. So the varnish basically has to be thinned and then sprayed on with a spray gun or a spray can. So it really comes in handy and looks good too. Okay, thanks guys. So check out my other video about my Thunderbird that I posted some time back, and then y'all can relate it to this video also. Thanks and see y'all.